Good morning, Holy Spirit, for such a beautiful day given to humanity. Heavenly Father, thank you for keeping us safe from the enemy's power, setting us apart and uniting us through your truth. Dear Lord, we praise you that your love lives in us by the Holy Spirit to reveal Jesus' character and presence, giving us confidence as we work for your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen. Friends, have you experienced the joy of knowing that you are being prayed for? Everyone loves being prayed for. And when the one praying is Jesus, which is a double joy. Jesus prayed and is praying for you because you belong to him and the Father. He treasures your relationship with him. Do you have special times reserved only for praying? Remember, Jesus regularly went to a quiet place and talked to God. In John chapter 17, is the longest prayer of Jesus recorded in the Bible. It marked the end of Jesus' earthly ministry, but looked forward to the ongoing ministry of the immediate and future disciples as well. The entire chapter of John chapter 17, known as the high priestly prayer of Jesus, from it we learn that the world is a tremendous battleground where the forces under Satan's power and those under God's authority are at war. Satan and his forces are motivated by bitter hatred for Christ and his church and his forces and his militant church. Jesus prayed for himself. Then Jesus prayed for his disciples, including those of us who follow him today. Jesus prayed that God, the Father, will keep his chosen believers safe from Satan's power, setting them apart and making them pure and holy, uniting them through his truth. As the high priest of the new covenant, I pray for all who through his immediate disciples witness will later believe in him, such as you and I. Jesus tells us clearly here, by knowing God, the Father himself, through his Son, Jesus Christ, do we get eternal life. In a sense, eternal life requires entering into a personal relationship with God in Jesus Christ. When we admit our sin and turn away from it, Christ's love lives in us by the Holy Spirit. Knowing that the hour or time has come, referring to his imminent death on the cross and his motivation, doing everything his Father told him to do, he did not indulge in self-exaltation, but focus all his attention on the cross of Calvary. Everything he did was done to bring glory to God. Even when he prayed that God should glorify him, he was looking ahead to his glorious resurrection. Jesus' primary purpose for his earthly sojourn is by demonstrating the love of God for us as well as for all people, for all humanity. Jesus passionately prays for his disciples to be united in harmony and love as the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit are united. The strongest of all unions. Friends, if you belong to Christ Jesus, his prayers cover you too. And I believe you are. However, apart from Judas, the one headed for destruction, who was lost because he betrayed Jesus and never sought forgiveness, the good shepherd kept his own sheep safe. This is a challenge to parents. This is a challenge to leaders. This is a challenge to my fellow pastors. Yes, they have responsibility. We all have responsibility and accountability for their children and for their followers. Remember that God has his timetable for events in our lives, and we must prayerfully walk along with him, with Jesus. Events do not occur by luck. With Jesus, events do not occur by accident. Instead, by God's ordained timing. Father God, help us. Help us, Lord, to be like our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Lord, help me to be like my Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and to focus on the things that advance your kingdom. Amen. For listening, and God bless you. Good morning, my brothers and sisters in the Lord.